This podcast is brought to you by Most Valuable Podcasts, saving your day from boredom with the best podcasting entertainment.
What's up, what's up, everybody? Ricky Widmer here, along with fellow man-child, Johnny Carlin.
Grass tastes bad.
And we are back for the Rick and Johnny podcast here on the Most Valuable Podcast Network. And we are back to talk about what nerdy news,
lots
entertainment
of nerdy news.
News, movie news. We kind of hit all of it. In today's podcast, though, we're going to be looking more on the nerd side and the gaming side. We're going to look at a possible Black Widow solo film, or the idea of one, from Thor director Taika Waititi.
Yeah.
Then we're also going to look at kind of a philosophy when it comes to gaming. Not necessarily a game, a certain philosophy and a certain kind of question
I mean,
that
it's
has
brought
arose.
Up because of a certain game, but no.
Because
it's...
of Cuphead, it has been brought up, but we are going to dive into that. Then we're going to look at Justice League and should we be excited for the villain
should we?
Of Steppenwolf. Well, I guess we'll have to get to it. And it is our Halloween podcast, so Johnny has his Nightmare Before Christmas.
This is Halloween.
I guess I went with a Halloween thing.
I mean, Stranger Things is Halloween-esque. It's almost like a horror movie.
But it was more, I'm wearing my Stranger Things shirt because
it came
Stranger
out this
Things
week.
Has come out. And that leads me right into, before we start the podcast, a little housekeeping. Number one.
Hey, you got it right.
Number one is just for Rick and Johnny fans of... We're going to do a Stranger Things review next week. So next Monday is when we will release our Stranger Things review. Give us some time to watch it. And then we will get that to you guys, what we thought about season two. Then other things. Number one, go rate our podcast on iTunes. Go to iTunes, type in Onside Kick, Fast Break, Primetime Podcast, Rick and Johnny. Go and rate all of our podcasts on iTunes. And then the last thing is check out patreon.com/mostvaluablepodcast. Jake. Patrick, our new guy, I want to thank you for submitting and pledging to the $10 tier. He's going to be on a podcast next month along with Jake Johnny. So now we got two of our wonderful fans going to be on podcast next month. You can be on one too. Just check out patreon.com/mostvaluablepodcast. Housekeeping is over, Johnny.
Okay.
We're going to get right into it. We're in your realm. We're in the Marvel side of things. We'll end the podcast on my side with DC.
I mean, it's like a nice little transfer in middle and then goes to the end.
And then we kind of move it from side to side.
Yeah.
But the reason why we bring this up is because Thor 3 director, Taika Waititi, brought up in an interview with IO9. He was discussing the latest film, discussing Thor Ragnarok, and... He was asked about, he mentioned that, I'd like to do a Black Widow movie. However, he wants to do it as a comedy. And his exact quote is, as I read here, in all honesty, I reckon I could probably bring something pretty unique to any of the franchises. So I'd love to see Black Widow. I'd like to see Black Widow as something crazy, but a bit funnier than we expect it to be. Because we know her story. And it's very sullen and very dark, and her history is very dark. But what's the funny version of that? What's the more entertaining version of that end quote? And Johnny, I just want to ask you this. Could a Black Widow solo movie be a comedy?
That's a really tough question, honestly, because I always saw it as you kind of need to go with, instead of the newer route, which I get with it, I get it. That's why he would kind of get that's in the sense why he wants to make it a comedy. Mm-hmm. It would make it fit better in the newer route Marvel's going.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like her backstory fits better. I mean, if it's a backstory one, I doubt we're going to do a backstory one now that everyone actually knows it. I don't know if that would necessarily be good as a comedy. Otherwise, I mean, I would say a good example would probably kind of like a Kingsman comedy in a sense where... It's funny. It's got humor to it, but it's also got serious moments.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't, like, straight up comedy, I wouldn't be able to see that very well.
No, my exact answer to this when I proposed the question and thought about this was, if you are going to do, and this is just for an origin style.
Yes, an origin.
For Black Widow, because there are different stories you can do.
Yeah.
But if we're thinking of the origin story for Black Widow, or we're thinking about anything... pre-S.H.I.E.L.D., where she is before S.H.I.E.L.D., basically.
Yeah.
No, you can't.
I agree.
You can't, because the way I look at it is that movie that's either coming out or has come out with Jennifer Lawrence.
Yeah.
It's called Sparrow.
Right.
It's basically
Sparrow, right?
Yeah, it's basically Black Widow.
It's
basically what it is.
The off-brand Black Widow movie.
Is Black Widow. And I feel like you can't do that kind of a movie as a comedy.
You can't put in the
details and the exact things she went through in a comedy.
No.
You can't do it.
You can't really joke. It's not really something that you can make a huge joke about, mm-hmm. honestly. It's just, how do you, I mean, you can, but do you really?
You can't do it in the sense of like Guardians
yes.
or in the sense of like what Thor 3 looks like it's going to be.
Exactly.
We have not seen it. We are going to see it this upcoming Thursday for our movie review to come out
exactly.
this next week. But I think you can't do that as a comedy. You can't because,
not the origin story.
Because then it seems like you're playing light into tragic events. And I get it. There might be people out there that go, well, you can do whatever you want. Don't let PC culture keep you down. But on the sense of it, I just think there's no way to do that without offending a mass group of people because you're playing light to torture and other elements that she had to go through in her backstory.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely not like her if we're going to do an origin story,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to go with a blatant no.
Yeah.
If we're going to go just pre-Shield,
mm-hmm.
And even in her origin story, and it kind of snowballs as it goes farther down the timeline.
Mm-hmm.
Origin story, no, just like the little quips she makes. That should
yeah.
be the funny parts, little quips here and there. Or pre-Shield, maybe a little bit more funniness to it, not
mm-hmm.
a lot, because it's like she's still an assassin, she's still just killing people. She's still kind of working for like whoever she was with in the Red Room,
mm-hmm.
where she went her procedure.
Yeah.
And then it's kind of like you could make a, not origin exactly, but it's like a pre-Shield becoming Shield member where she actually comes into contact with Clinton Barton, and
mm-hmm.
you can actually make maybe a little funny thing going on between that.
I'm glad you brought that up.
Yes.
Because that's what I thought of, was the only way you could make a Black Widow movie a comedy
mm-hmm.
is if you do it, whether it's right before S.H.I.E.L.D. or when they start at S.H.I.E.L.D., where it's basically a Black Widow, Hawkeye, buddy cop movie.
Yeah.
That's the only thing I can think of where you make it a comedy. Everything else would have to be after S.H.I.E.L.D.
Budapest.
Yes.
That would be, we could get a Budapest movie finally.
Okay.
Remember from Avengers 1?
Yes.
Remember, it reminds me of the time mm-hmm. in Budapest. You and I remember Budapest very differently.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that would be the one where I can see a very funny.
Thank you for reminding me. Because
yes.
I originally said yes, like, yeah, sure, Johnny, I know what you're talking about.
No,
thank you for
yeah.
explaining, because now I do remember
and
that scene.
In case no one else did,
yeah.
too. I said, anyways, that would make a great buddy cop movie, because
mm-hmm.
they made a joke about it in a movie already.
Yeah.
Otherwise, her origin, no, except for the little quips she makes.
Mm-hmm.
Pre-Shield. Maybe a little bit extra when it comes to like her quips and then like the interaction between her and Barton.
Mm-hmm.
But otherwise, like when it comes to like, for example, Budapest, that could be a buddy cop movie. That could be a comedy.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then maybe after, but like Clint's retired technically or after he's in jail now.
There's an interesting thing about that.
Oh, actually, we have to wait and see what happens
mm-hmm.
with Infinity War. So I'm
yeah.
not even going to say that.
There's an interesting thing because I'm going to bring this up kind
yeah.
of in passing. There's a theory out there
okay.
that we could see Hawkeye turn into Ronan,
ooh.
Who is his, it's the other alter ego that he went after, in the comics, went into after Civil War.
Yes.
The one where he has the mask on and he's got the sword.
Yeah.
There's a theory out there that we're moving towards that
with
the Hawkeye in the movie.
That'd be cool. See that? I mean, I would like to see too. They haven't really. Well, they're kind of. It seems like they're making a nudge at in Infinity Wars with some
mm-hmm.
of the costuming I've seen on pictures online.
Yeah,
they're kind of going towards Captain America Nomad,
mm-hmm.
where he like the star is gone on the chest.
Yeah,
the of the Avengers is gone,
mm-hmm.
and so anything that details him to Captain America
is
kind
gone.
Of going away. And I would at least like not call him Nomad, but let's make a reference.
Yeah.
I would love to hear that because
mm-hmm.
that's what he's going for now. He's got the beard, so he's like not your typical Captain America anymore.
And I mean, you bring up Captain America, that makes me think, is there any story that you could tell
mm-hmm.
where it's a Black Widow movie with Steve Rogers, because there was a little bit of comedy and back and forth
in Winter Soldier
between Natalia and Steve.
You know what? I can't think of one that like would be the two of them other than we got what we got in not Civil War, Winter Soldier, because that's like that was going on then.
Mm-hmm.
Now, like afterwards, there's like little hints of time in between, but not ton, because then we got Civil War. And they're on opposite sides, where she's kind of like on the waiver line about it. And then afterwards, he's on the run. She's actually, is she on the run now? Because it looks like that from Infinity Wars. She
technically is.
Because she's blonde now.
Yes.
Scarlet Witch is more red than she, red hair than when she was born.
And Scarlet Witch is living with Vision.
Yes, which was weird because he's not on the run.
No.
Whatever. We'll find out when Infinity Wars comes out on that part. Mm-hmm. But yeah, so I mean, there might be something you can do in there, but I would lean more towards, let's do a pre-story of Budapest. That my number one pick, if you're going to make it a comedy.
So like a buddy cop of Budapest.
Buddy cop Budapest. Because as soon as Avengers, as soon as the first Avengers movie came out, and that stuff came out, I saw a ton of stuff online of what happened in Budapest. I want to see what happened in Budapest.
Just because they mentioned it?
Yeah, just because they mentioned it and they made a joke about it.
Mm-hmm. I feel like if you're going to do a comedy with Black Widow, you're going to have to do it with another character. Another one that I just looked at the Screen Rant article and I'll throw it out. What about a Black Widow Hulk movie? Maybe like a rom-com?
Yeah, you could do that.
A rom-com with like Hulk and Black Widow.
The little things that happen in between.
I almost said
that
a ro-com. I'm like, no, that's not right. A rom-com, romantic comedy. Because they had that that little twining together.
I thought romantic comedy was a romantic communist.
No, not that. No, a little bit of a rom-com. Could they do that with Black Widow and Hulk?
They could. I just want to know where it would lay out in the timeline is the only thing. Like, Marvel is about keeping their timeline.
Except after
Infinity Wars.
This movie would definitely be after Infinity War.
It would.
Timeline gone.
Yeah, I mean,
they're breaking their timeline with Infinity War.
They are. So in that case, then it could work. It just depends on all this is the problem is like what happens in Infinity Wars.
Yeah. Infinity War and Avengers 4. Because what it looks like is they're still keeping the part one, part two.
Yeah, it just.
But it looks like Infinity War is going to be the Black Order and Thanos assembling the gauntlet.
Yeah.
And then it looks like Avengers 4 is going to be, we need to stop the gauntlet.
Yeah.
And that's maybe where Captain Marvel comes in.
Yeah. That's
what. Because we'll get the Captain Marvel movie in between Infinity War and Avengers 4.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, that's still kind of a problem of like where. Because it's probably going to come, well, with the planning, it might come after Avengers 4 anyways.
Well, it would, because this isn't even.
It's just a thought.
Let's put it this way. If this movie was a child, this movie's not even a speck in its father's eye right now.
Yeah, it's
That's how, like, pre-production we are on this idea of a Black Widow.
It's more
film.
Of just a thought right now.
Pen has not hit paper.
No. But that would be the thing, is like, there's too much questioning what happens after these movies, after Infinity Wars 1, or after Infinity Wars and after Avengers 4.
Plus, you know, and the thing with this is we're getting this information from a director, from Taika Waititi, where it's basically, hey, I would love to do this.
Yeah.
This is not Marvel
saying well, we're having this
we're
done.
Going to think about doing a Black Widow movie. Like, Kevin Feige has not come out and said, yeah, we're thinking about a Black Widow movie.
Mm-hmm,
like
exactly.
Marvel knows what movies they're going to do. And I kind of feel like Black Widow, although she was the first female superhero in this universe to be put out there, the thing I worry about is that I don't know if ScarJo will, because ScarJo is an A-list actor or actress. However, I just don't think the character has enough with a story to do a solo film just them, like a Wonder Woman. You can do it with Captain Marvel because Captain Marvel has A, more powers, B, has the intense of like universe on Earth, pre-Avengers, pre-Shield kind of a story, to where I don't think Black Widow, you could tell the kind of solo story, unless you do her origin, solo story, like DC did with Wonder Woman.
Yeah, exactly.
Because let's be honest, like, the one thing we miss with superhero films are solo female leads.
Exactly.
Like, Wonder Woman was it. Wonder Woman was the one to kick down the door and actually it be a fucking phenomenal movie.
It was.
To where it's like, wow, this isn't like, oh, wow, it's a good superhero movie for a female lead. It's like, wow, this is one of the best superhero movies I've seen so far.
Exactly. I mean, there've been other ones with female mm-hmm. leads. It's not because they're female leads. Mm-hmm. It's because the movie was just trash.
Aren't that good.
They weren't that good.
That's why I kind of want, I know this isn't superhero, but why I kind of want Tomb Raider to be good.
Yeah, exactly.
Because you have that female lead. That's a two-prong approach, though,
mm-hmm.
because it's a female lead, but also it's a video game movie.
Yeah.
And I would like video game movies to get on the level of where we are with superhero movies.
That would be nice.
Where basically superhero movies are, back when we were growing up, superhero movies were a niche thing.
Yeah.
To where it was like, you like Batman? Fucking nerd. Where now it's basically, wow, Batman, it's a global, like, wow, Captain America. When we grew up, Captain America, I didn't even know who he was because I was on the DC side.
Exactly.
And because there was no, like, cartoon, no show with Captain America. And, I mean, really the only ones I remember from Marvel were X-Men, Spider-Man, and Iron Man.
Mm-hmm.
There was a Hulk one, but yeah, I didn't watch it. Those were mainly the three, and even the Iron Man one as a kid, I was kind of like, much. Whatever. It was mainly Spider-Man and X-Men.
Yeah.
But, I mean, now we're getting to the level where it's like, you see, like, every kid wants to be Captain America, wants to be Iron Man, wants to be Hulk. And this kind of nerd culture is kind of expanding out into a broader... The culture is becoming broader. That's what I'm trying to say.
It's becoming more mainstream. Mm-hmm. It's becoming bigger. Yeah, no, I agree. But back to...
Black Widow.
To have another female lead, the other problem is... Again, the direction Marvel's mm-hmm. going seems a bit different than, and this is going along with just her origin story mainly.
Yeah.
The thought going way different than her origin story. Mm-hmm. It's more of the tone of Iron Man 3, Captain America, Winter Soldier, Thor, mm-hmm. The Dark World. It's got to be darker. It's got to be definitely grittier than those even.
Mm-hmm.
And it's got to be, there's a lot, like, you can't make a comedy out of that.
No, you can't.
And then, and you go down the timeline as you go farther towards Infinity Wars and Avengers Part 4, mm-hmm. you can add more comedy elements to it. But I completely agree with you when you said you really kind of need a second main in there
mm-hmm.
to make it a comedy.
No, I don't think that a Black Widow film could work on its own. I don't. Unless it's the only one would be the origin, but I don't think we're ever going to get that.
I don't think so either. But I
don't think Marvel wants to go in that dark of a tone anymore.
No, that's
the other thing. They don't want to go Thor the Dark World.
Exactly. They don't want to go that dark a tone. I would say a Black Widow movie could work on its own,
mm-hmm.
but it can't be a comedy. Not on its own.
But this is where I want to turn the conversation onto you guys. What do you guys think? Could a comedy for Black Widow work? If it does, what would your story be? What would you want the main story to be? Let us know what you guys think down below in the comment section.